As you may know, Redbubble is the most popular free print-on-demand platform that enables designers to monetize their art by selling it on different products, like t-shirts, stickers, mugs, pillows, or masks. And because one of the best ways to improve your Redbubble shop is to get relevant analytics and feedback, then in this video, I will show you how to use Google Analytics to analyze traffic to Redbubble shop. Starting with 2021, Google has tweaked the analytics interface, but things are not so different at all. I assume you have already connected your Redbubble shop to your Google Analytics account. If not, I have an entire video dedicated to this topic. But for the others who have already set up the tracking code, then let's go to the Google Analytics dashboard. For some reason, Redbubble still doesn't support the new Analytics 4 tracking, so to get relevant data, you need to use the old all-website data analytics. Google Analytics has dozens and dozens of reports, but as a Redbubble seller, what reports should you be looking at? The first important report you should always start off within the platform are the week-over-week results. What do I mean by that? If you want to check out how your traffic is growing on a weekly basis, then the best practice is to compare it week over week. So, click on Audience and then click on the Overview. In the next step, we need to set up the date range. Firstly, select this week period. Then click on Compare to and select Previous Period. Then click on Apply button. As you can see, my Nick Empire shop on Redbubble, which is a shop I set up for tutorials only, is getting more traffic than previous week. I have over 50% new users and even more page views. This means I'm getting new visitors to my shop and they are looking at some of my designs. This is excellent, but what about organic traffic? I was putting much effort into SEO optimized listings. And I want to know how much organic traffic I get. There is a simple way to check the organic traffic. Go to Acquisition, click on All Traffic, and then select Channels. Because Redbubble does not send data of organic entries here, you cannot find out which keyword is driving most of your organic traffic, but you can see the amount of people who are seeing your designs thanks to Google. Set up the date to the beginning of the year and use the monthly chart to see the traffic growth. When you have a successful shop on Redbubble, then you should see three traffic sources: direct, organic, and paid. The paid traffic means that Redbubble is promoting your design with Google Ads, and they are only doing this because they believe the design will sell. The organic traffic is all the visitors that found your designs on Google. This means in Google search, shopping listing, or in the image section. The direct traffic is a combination of social media and Redbubble result pages. In other words, all your Pinterest, Facebook, or Instagram promotions, plus all the keywords you use in the tags section of your design listing that is ranking in the Redbubble results page. These metrics are great and they are showing you the growth of your Redbubble shop. But you have traffic but no sales. What is wrong with your shop? The most important metrics as a Redbubble seller has to use are hidden under the behavior section and in the overview analytics. Here, click on site content and select all pages. This is a place where you can see all the most visited pages from your shop. Here you can find out all the landing and exit pages. Exit pages are the last pages visitors of your designs have seen. And if the visitor purchased your design, then you will see here the checkout success page. The landing page, on the contrary, is a website page that the visitor used to enter your shop or design listing. As you can see, some people are checking my Orca design on socks. But I know there is no sale of this design. This means the design is not good enough to convince the visitor of the listing to buy it. If you are seeing lots of people checking your particular design, but there are no sale of it, then either the design is bad or it looks ugly on the product. My advice is to create a better design for this keyword and replace the old artwork with the new one. Do not create a new listing with the same keyword because you already have traffic and some authority in the Redbubble algorithm. So use it to your advantage and just replace the boring design with the new exciting one. Thanks for watching. If you find this video helpful, give it thumbs up and consider subscribing to the Nech Empire YouTube channel.